This is WPIX, New York.
Tonight, a big reward for the cold-blooded killer of a rookie New York cop. The new law to warn people about the dangers of toxic chemicals in food, water, and air. Jeff Lyons will tell us if Harrison Ford's new movie is really all that frantic. And 50 years old and still a superhero, Superman's golden birthday party.
From Channel 11, this is USA Tonight with Brad Holbrook and Sheila Steinbeck.
Good evening. Sheila has the night off. Tonight, Mayor Ed Koch is offering $10,000 to anyone who can help find the killer of a 22-year-old rookie cop. Officer Edward Byrne was gunned down execution style in Queens early today. Tonight, a massive manhunt is on to find the man who gunned him down. Eric Shawn reports.
Police Officer Edward Byrne was only 22 years old. He had been on the force less than 1 year, on the streets about 1 month. Last night, he was assigned to the rather routine shift of sitting alone in his patrol car, guarding the house of a threatened witness in a drug case. Instead, Byrne was the tragic target of a cold-blooded execution, apparently ordered by drug bosses from behind bars in Rikers Island. The attack came so swiftly in the night, Byrne had no time to reach for his gun, which remained in his holster. A shaken police commissioner, Benjamin Ward, likened the killing to an assassination.
I think it smacks more of a deliberate assassination attempt, an attempt to intimidate not just that witness, but all of you and all of the people in this city and in this country.
It was 3:30 in the morning when police say a light brown or tan Cutlass pulled alongside Officer Byrne's patrol car. A black man stepped out, his hands in his pockets, and then pulled out a heavy caliber gun, firing 5 shots point blank into the driver's side window. Police say Officer Byrne was hit with at least 3 shots in the head. He died 15 minutes later at the hospital.
It's really terrible. I have 8 children. I really feel bad. I feel very bad.
Officer Byrne was staking out a house that had allegedly been firebombed twice last November by local drug dealers. Its owner, a Guyanese immigrant named Arjun, was apparently a citizen doing his duty by refusing to surrender to the underside of this city. Arjun received death threats for cooperating with police and was a witness in an upcoming trial against alleged dealers.
I'd say it could have been you. I had that post a couple of weeks ago. Everybody does their share over there.
Officer Byrne was single. He lived with his parents in Massapequa, Long Island. His father had been a high-ranking police official in the 1970s. His family said Byrne's life dream was to become a cop. They are now planning his funeral. This is Eric Shawn.
And tonight, police are asking anyone who might have information to call a special police hotline number. The number is area code 718-520-0444. That's 718-520-0444. All calls will be kept confidential. Funeral services for Officer Byrne will be held on Monday in Seaford, Long Island. Earlier this week, the Independent News reported that New York City was losing the battle in the war against drugs. Today, Officer Byrne was gunned down in an area of Queens that residents call Crack Alley. Can New York City put a roadblock on the drug highway? And where do we go from here? Alec Roberts has a follow-up report.
Not since ambushes by the Black Liberation Army have police officers been the target of assassins' bullets. And that's an ominous development in the battle against drugs.
Many police officers feel that the murder of Officer Byrne escalates the violence to a new level. While the killings by the Black Liberation Army had at least some political motivation, the motive of the drug barons is profit, pure and simple. And the message they send is that a cop's life is just as cheap as anybody else's.
When we are threatened, the whole city is threatened.
Sterling Johnson, the city's special narcotics prosecutor, says the deliberate assassination of Officer Byrne is a byproduct of the drug war, a war we are losing.
We are losing the war on drugs, and if this were a prize fight, they would stop the fight. We are not committed at all. When I say we, I'm talking about the nation.
Mayor Koch, too, expresses frustration at the city's inability to stop the flood of drugs in the city.
The police are not able to prevent drugs from being sold in the city. Last year, 68,000 people were arrested. This year, 80,000. They'll be turned back out on the streets in many, if not most, of those cases by the courts.
In the turf wars in Queens and other areas of the city, drug dealers have become more brazen, less afraid of what used to be taboo, killing witnesses in their trials, shooting cops. And of society's response, there is bitterness among those who uphold the law.
And we see that on occasion when there is a homicide in this city. But those people that are the noisiest, when those homicides occur, seem to be the most silent. When one of our police officers, one of the protectors of all of the citizens in this town, is killed.
In New York, this is Alec Roberts reporting.
Meantime, tonight, Dutchess County executives are calling for calm on the eve of a mass rally in Poughkeepsie to support black teenager Tawana Brawley. County Executive Lucille Patterson is urging participants and observers to avoid any violence. Meanwhile, State Attorney General Robert Abrams says Tawana Brawley's case will go before the grand jury despite stonewalling by her attorneys.
We will have the impanelment of a grand jury. And my view is that that grand jury will use its fullest powers to develop documentary and all other information and evidence that's going to be necessary, that I deem essential and necessary for the effective prosecution of this case. I think voluntary cooperation is far more preferable, desirable. You don't have as strong a witness if you compel a victim in a case to come forward. That witness has far greater credibility and will provide you far greater and strengthened testimony if that witness comes forward in a voluntary fashion.
The grand jury will also investigate claims by Tawana Brawley's aunt, Juanita Brawley, that she's the only person with information critical to the case. So far, she's refused to disclose what that information is. The man accused of killing another man with a karate kick is free on bail tonight. 20-year-old Robert Wallace Jr. is released on $100,000 bail after pleading innocent to charges of murder and manslaughter. The alleged karate killer got into an argument with 24-year-old Daniel Klagsbrun outside a bar near Broadway and West 79th in Manhattan. According to authorities, one of Klagsbrun's friends made fun of Wallace's boots. Klagsbrun was allegedly kicked in the head and neck. He died 2 days later. Coming up on USA Tonight, who's running the country? That's the question many people, including a lot of Americans, are asking in Panama tonight. Jeffrey Lyons will be along to review Harrison Ford's new movie, Frantic. And look up in the sky. It's a bird. It's a plane. Nah, it's just a 50-year-old superhero. We'll be right back.
USA Tonight, brought to you by Taster's Choice.
From those far-off days of Camelot, John F. Kennedy's reported mistress decides to tell a lie about JFK and the mob, and how Jack's girlfriend allegedly carried secret envelopes between the Oval Office and the mob. People, that's what we're all about.
I just got dentures, but it hasn't slowed me down.
Size of me to 45, want to hear 45, 45.
Fixident and forget it. Fixident helps fix loose spots for a strong hold that lasts longer than any leading cream.
Two, I hear 25, want to hear 25, 25. 30.
Use Fixident and forget it.
Pressure and congestion, all together major symptoms of sinus complex. You need to feel better, but not drowsy. You need Sinutab 2 No Drowsiness Formula, so you feel altogether better and awake.
There's one more thing you can do for your heart plan. Take a natural omega-3 supplement. But take Promega, the one preferred by heart specialists when they learned only Promega has more omega-3, cholesterol-free.
The greatest city in the world. What better place for a university? A university with a distinguished alumni, which includes the governors of New York and California. A university with a history of success and a tradition of opportunity. It's the least expensive private university in New York State and the largest Catholic university in the country. Yes, the city is New York, and the university is St. John's.
You know, I've been talking to you about Mazdas for some time now, but talking can't really explain how great Mazda cars drive. You're going to have to discover that for yourself. And to tempt you in that direction, Mazda's putting its money where its mouth is.
The Mazda Test Drive Challenge. If you test drive a Mazda car and buy one of these competitors' comparable models, Mazda will give you a $200 U.S. savings bond. But if you buy a Mazda, you'll get a $500 savings bond.
Now that's impressive.
The power struggle continues in the nation of Panama tonight. The country's National Assembly has now appointed a new president, removing Eric Arturo Del Valle from office. This after Del Valle tried to fire military strongman General Manuel Noriega, who's wanted here in the U.S. on drug trafficking charges. President Reagan acknowledges that our options in Panama are somewhat limited.
Well, there are some limits on what we can do, we're looking at that situation and our people are meeting on it to see if there is anything that we can do.
Would we use military force, sir?
No, I don't think that's an answer.
The U.S. does continue to recognize Del Valle as Panama's legitimate leader. In the Middle East, Secretary of State George Shultz is being followed every step of the way by hundreds of demonstrators as he meets with various Israeli officials trying to help them work out a peace settlement in the occupied territories. No word yet on exactly what Shultz's proposals are. Here at home, leaders of the Assemblies of God Church are still talking about what to do with Jimmy Swaggart. Most of the 300 calls they get every hour are from people who say his punishment of 3-month suspension should be more severe. Meantime, a friend of the woman who says she was Swaggart's hooker says he's going to sell her story to the highest bidder. That's the American way, he says. Still to come on USA Tonight, bad news in the fight against prostate cancer. Bob Harris says a little snow falls into everyone's life from time to time.
We're awful quiet.
And will Jeffrey Lyons be absolutely frantic over a movie by the star of the Indiana Jones flicks? Stay with us and find out.
And she hasn't come back.
He had his arm around her.
He could have had a gun.
Like this.
Yeah.
I want you.
I thought I had finally found perfection. After all, these high nutrition cereals were made just right. They tasted just right. Somehow they even felt just right. But then Kellogg's put more fruit in this version of Just Right and crunchy fiber nuggets in this one. So if there's more fruit and new fiber nuggets in these cereals that were already just right, what are they now? Just righter? Just perfect? Or just...
It's still just right, only better.
How about just right on? Or exactly.
These days, you gotta stay on top of things, because times have changed. This small pickup, the Ford Ranger, now outsells Toyota. And what's more, Ranger has more features and a lower sticker price than Toyota. Features like tachometer, interval wipers, and light group. Plus, Ranger's got a fuel-injected engine. And to top it off, Ranger has a 6-year, 60,000-mile powertrain warranty. Toyota doesn't. Sorry to burst your bubble, Toyota, but Ranger's on top now.
Now, during Ford's Leadership Celebration, get a $500 cash bonus on Ranger. Take one small tamboy and plunk him down in the middle of the big city, and you got the makings for a whole lot of fun. It's the movie that got America doing the two-step, riding the bull, and talking in a funny accent.
Now do two-step?
You bet.
John Travolta, Deborah Winger.
I love you, sissy.
Urban Cowboy, Saturday at 8 here on Channel 11.
It's three-ring value time at your New York, New Jersey Buick dealers, so I dressed for the occasion. In ring one, save up to $1,200 on Buicks with value option packages. In ring two, get up to $1,000 cash back from Buick. In ring three, test drive a new Buick and get two passes to Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey Circus, opening at Meadowlands Arena March 8th, Nassau Coliseum March 15th, and Madison Square Garden March 23rd. But hurry before the circus passes and Buicks disappear. Not me, the Buicks.
USA Tonight's Health Beat, brought to you by Anison 3.
Word tonight that a Food and Drug Administration committee has reportedly voted against recommending approval of a drug to help treat prostate cancer, but industry analysts say the drug, developed by Shearing Plow, is being considered for use with another medication to treat a form of prostate cancer. FDA officials and Shearing officials have not confirmed these reports. Restaurants, gas stations, and factories in California will be displaying new warnings starting tomorrow. It's all part of a 1986 law, which is about to go into effect now, warning residents about 29 chemicals that can cause cancer or birth defects. Chemical companies are more worried about the second phase of the law, which goes into effect in November. It puts strict limits on chemical dumping. And we'd like to remind you that a week from Monday, on March 7th, WPIX-TV will present a one-hour special program on AIDS called AIDS Lifeline. The program is designed to bring you up to date on the new developments on this deadly virus. That's AIDS Lifeline, Monday night, March 7th at 8.
USA Tonight's Health Beat, brought to you by Anison 3.
I don't give patients pain relievers myself, but as a hospital volunteer, I see the medicine nurses give out. Instead of Tylenol, patients here get aspirin-free Anison 3.
One of the nation's largest hospital systems has replaced Tylenol tablets with Anison 3. It has the same aspirin-free medicine that's in Tylenol, same strength, but Anison 3 costs them less.
When I saw Anison 3 in my hospital, I knew I could use it for my headaches, and I found it can cost less, too.
Aspirin-free Anison 3, the better choice.
Taking more pills than you'd like for minor pain? Try Aspercream. Rubbing Aspercream in brings fast relief to minor muscle pain. Without aspirin or pills or side effects they may cause. And there's no odor. Aspercream. Pain relief without aspirin or odor. Remarkable.
In 1 week, I lost 7 pounds. 7 pounds.
The Slim Fast Pledge. Give us a week, we'll take off the weight. Each Slim Fast shake is a delicious, nutritious, low-calorie meal.
1 week and the weight was gone.
Give us a week, we'll take off the weight.
You may know the name Harrison Ford. It translates into big bucks at the box office. His latest film called Frantic, and our critic Jeffrey Lyons is here to tell us if this one's a big box office hit.
Afraid not, Brad. With Roman Polanski, who after all directed Knife in the Water and Chinatown, directing his screenplay, which he co-wrote, and with Harrison Ford, star of more big-grossing movies than any other actor in the history of the movies as the star, you'd think Frantic would be a gripping thriller, but you'd be wrong.
Frantic is a thriller without thrills. Harrison Ford plays a doctor who goes to Paris with his wife for a convention, but they pick up the wrong bag from the airport and the real owners kidnap his wife in return for the bag. For the rest of the movie, however, Harrison Ford plays it as a brooding, angry man, unable to get help from anybody. But he's very good at that, so he, as a result, is far better than the plotting screenplay. Emmanuel Signer, the newest Polanski discovery, is his only lead. The U.S. Embassy will give him no help because it's filled with bureaucratic hacks.
We can assist you in communicating with the French police. We can put a little pressure on the Ministry of Interior, but this is their country. It's their jurisdiction. We can't just send a posse out after her.
So his only hope is, of course, the girl, who here bumbles an attempted switch with the kidnappers. This is the only exciting scene in Frantic.
Michelle, watch out! Go!
You've seen all you need from Frantic, because Frantic is a film which will have you frantic, wondering what a fine picture it should have been. I'm Jeffrey Lyons. Brad?
Okay, thank you, Jeffrey. Looking at our weather out there, it's a little flaky right now, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, but nothing to get frantic about.
No? Nothing.
Absolutely okay. Not. No, I'll tell you right now, this is going to be a little bit more than a dusting. That's about it. And I don't mean 4 inches. I'm talking about an inch or two of snow in the northern and western suburbs and maybe a dusting in the city, Brad.
Okay.
Light deal. 31 degrees, famous last words, of course. The humidity of 53%. The winds are southerly at 7 miles an hour, and the barometer is steady at 30.05. Yes, and we do have some snow flurries here in Midtown and some light snow in some of the northern and western suburbs. The weather system that is bringing us the unsettled weather for at least the first half of the weekend is a Manitoba low. It started out in Manitoba, Canada, and is driving southeastward across the Great Lakes as we speak tonight. Clouds way out ahead of it, and, well, we have the very latest radar now for you, showing very light snow, basically, all across eastern Pennsylvania, parts of northwestern New Jersey, and into southeastern New York State. And that is making a move in our direction as well. So overnight, light snow in our area, a dusting in some places, and it could be a little slippery by tomorrow morning. At least we don't have a major rush hour to deal with on a Saturday morning. Some folks I know do work on Saturday. Anyway, that low will continue its movement. And if it keeps moving, and everything suggests that it will, even though it'll slow down a little bit, as long as it remains progressive and keeps going along and doesn't stall, we're just going to have light snow at times tomorrow, that it leaves tomorrow night, and coming in behind it will be drier air for Sunday with a little high-pressure system, so we'll see some sunshine develop here on Sunday. Temperatures overnight, certainly cold enough for the snow and for some icy conditions by morning. 28 degrees in town and near 20 in the most distant suburbs. Our 5-day forecast says that tomorrow will be cloudy all day, it'll be chilly, and there will be on and off light snow. 1 to 2 inches possible north and west in town, less than that everywhere else. 35 for high, then clouds giving way to a little bit of sunshine during Sunday, highs in the upper 30s, and sunny and a little milder early next week. Enjoy the weekend, even enjoy the flakes. There'll just be a few of them. Brad?
Okay, Bob, you have yourself a good weekend, too.
Thank you.
The Nets have a new basketball coach tonight, huh?
Familiar name, huh?
Yeah.
Willis Reed, not official yet, but reliable sources report that he will be the new Nets coach beginning Monday. We'll have that story. Plus, the Rangers are out of the cellar. Believe it or not, we've got the evidence.
Race fans, it's the Ford Budweiser U.S. Hot Rod Truck Bowl Winter Championship. Blasting into Madison Square Garden this Saturday and Sunday. Featuring the $50,000 Battle of the Monster Truck Challenge Series with Bigfoot, Giant, and Excalibur. Taking on the half-tank, half-truck beast from the east. Plus wheel-standing trick trucks, Orange Blossom Special, and Midnight Express. See wild, screaming, funny cars. Tickets now. All ticket run outlets and the Madison Square Garden box office. Saturday, 7:30 p.m. Sunday, 1:30 p.m. Madison Square Garden. It's awesome.
About that trip you've been meaning to take? TWA says take it now. That wander the back lots of the Hollywood studio trip. That cable car to Fisherman's Wharf to look at the bridge trip. That splashing around and catching the rays trip, or any other trip, anywhere in the U.S. Not all fares are refundable or available on all flights. Other significant restrictions apply. But at these prices, if you've been putting off a trip, put it back on. Today's TWA.
Because of currency fluctuations, this five-passenger Mercedes now costs an improbable $70,000. For the same money, you could have this elegant six-passenger Cadillac DeVille. In fact, for that money, you can have two DeVilles, his and hers, with enough left to pay a chauffeur's wages for a year. See your Cadillac Tri-Statesman. Why pay more money for luxury when you can have more luxury for your money?
I'll never give up my Cadillac.
Feel fresh all day with Shield.
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, fresh. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, fresh. Feel fresh the whole day through with Shield. Shield deodorant soap. Oh, when the clock strikes 6, 7, 2, a Shield will still be gone for you. Cause Shield protection feels so right. It keeps you fresh from day to night. Don't feel fresh the whole day through with Shield. Fresh all day with Shield.
Is it safe to say that this is the most excitement we've had this hockey season?
Well, the Rangers, certainly. The Rangers had been in the cellar since November. Picture yourself in a cellar since November. You come out, you have bloodshot eyes, you're ready to strangle. Well, tonight they got out of it, and they vaulted ahead of the Devils and Pittsburgh. And now they will turn their venom on the rest of the division. This is a horror story. Let's take a look at the highlights. It happened at the Meadowlands. 2-1, same as last night's score. Power play. Watch Dion's shot. This is unbelievable. Off one skate, off another skate, and behind the goalie. You knew then they were going to win. Shorthanded goal given up by the Rangers. Dion loses it to Brickley. He gives it to Brown. He finds the top shelf. 1-1. Second period, here's the winner. Nyland set it up. Fierce checking here. Goes after that puck. Gets it. Gets it out to Patrick. Cross-ice to McIver with a howitzer blast. That was the winner. 2-1, Rangers. All right, the Knicks are playing at Golden State tonight. They're in the first quarter trailing by one, looking for their second consecutive road win. They played last night, as you know, the Clippers. Tonight it's Golden State, so the chances are good. Tonight, the Nets lost by 30-something to the Pistons. Autopsy indicates poisonous sneakers. All right, here's Rodman to Lambeer. Look at that defense. Isn't that tough? Here's the Pearl driving, and as usual, comes up with nothing. Knocked away by Isaiah to Dumars, nobody home, easy layup. Isaiah then feeds Mahorn, who finished with a career-high 34 points, final 137-109, and the Nets have announced, as we have from reliable sources, that Willis Reed will be the new coach of the Nets starting on Monday. In Denver, as usual, Denver winning at home against the Sixers as they play the third quarter. The Celtics, with Larry Bird getting 28 in the first half, played only part of the second half, finished with 32, demolished Milwaukee. Atlanta, 15-point winner over Indiana. Jordan had 52 points, but not enough. Portland playing very well on the road, wins there. San Antonio upsets Houston by 4, and Utah leads the Lakers by 15, just starting the second quarter. At the Olympics, Bonnie Blair went for her second gold medal. She got one on Monday night. Here she is in the 1,000 meters. Not a bad performance, but not good enough. It got her the bronze medal, and the winner was her East German rival, Krista Rothenberg. She came in second to win the silver medal on Monday. Tonight she was at her peak, and when you think about it, sometimes there's a little luck involved. You've got to be at your peak on that particular night. Who knows if they race tomorrow night, but she wins the gold medal for East Germany. Soviets, by the way, defeated Sweden in hockey 7-1, so they win the gold medal. Ricky Henderson reported to the Yankees today. Well, they got the right team anyway, huh? At the races, the double at Roosevelt, E&H, 176-40. Triple, there wasn't any because of a shortage of horses, so there was just an exacta in the third, CE, 1380. At the big A, F&H in the double, 191-40. Triple, KAH, 162 and change. And the feature was run by Run Genuine 1260, repeating from reliable sources, although it hasn't been confirmed by the Nets, Willis Reed will take over the Nets beginning on Monday. Brad?
When you say that they didn't have enough horses to run a triple, does that mean there were only two horses? Or?
No, no, you have to have a minimum of like 7 or 8 horses to run the triple.
Or else the track loses money.
Well, it gets complicated.
Okay,
Brad.
Some other time we'll explain it. Thank you. Finally, tonight, by all accounts, or at least the ones you read in the Daily Planet, It is supposed to be one super birthday celebration. Superman turns 50 tonight, and hundreds showed up downtown to mark the occasion. As Ed Miller reports, even at 50, though, he can still leap a tall building with a single bound.
The Adventures of Superman.
Few heroes span the generations like Superman. He may have been your father's hero, and he may also be your son's.
More powerful than a locomotive. Able to leap tall buildings at a single bound.
Tonight, thousands of his loyal fans celebrated Superman's 50th birthday in downtown Metropolis, which looks very much like New York.
Give me a super!
Super!
There were Superman souvenirs, a slideshow of the man in tights, special effect pictures for the kids, original clips from the old radio and television shows, and dozens of eager children, each with his own reason for coming.
He flies.
Then he fights criminals.
He's nice and strong.
He's nice and strong?
Yeah.
Superman, who can change the course of mighty rivers, bend steel in his bare hands.
Whether we like it or not, Superman has changed the course of American culture and folklore. He's done more for phone booths than AT&T. But more importantly, he has taught generations of kids the difference between right and wrong, and that standing up for justice can make you a hero.
Yeah, a guy that can't be beat, that's on our side.
Brings back wonderful memories.
Superman is better than most men I know. And I used to think I was Superwoman, but of course I crashed to Earth, you know who that is.
Also present to mark the birthday, a man who bills himself as Super Mayor.
Superman establishes the proposition, which is that good will always overcome evil. Now, I believe in that proposition, but Superman does it very quickly. Sometimes with us who are not so super, it takes a little longer.
Yes, it's Superman, strange visitor from another planet who came to Earth with powers and abilities far beyond those of mortal men.
DC Comics now publishes the Superman comic books, and they want New Yorkers to know that while reaching 50 can be shocking for us mortals, you can sleep easily, for Superman will go on and on. In Soho, I'm Ed Miller.
That'll do it for the Friday, February 26th edition of USA Tonight. I'm Brad Holbrook. Thanks very much for being with us. One program reminder for all you early birds. Tomorrow morning at 6 and Sunday morning at 6:30, the Christian Science Monitor reports will continue its series on the world of Islam. Have a good weekend. We hope to see you back here Monday night at 7:30 and 11 on Channel 11. Good night.
WPIX has news bureaus in New Jersey on the Rutherford campus of Fairleigh Dickinson University, 223 Montross Avenue, and on Long Island at 3000 Hempstead Turnpike, Levittown.
Coming up next on Channel 11, The Honeymooners.
A recent WPIX editorial supported a plan by Andrew Cuomo and Westchester County Executive Andrew O'Rourke to build housing for the homeless in various communities in the northern suburbs. Several communities have now agreed to provide land for the developments, and the project is moving forward. Even so, the Westchester residents we heard from were something less than enthusiastic about the proposal. Mary Carras of Bedford sent along these comments. I'm very much aware of the housing problem, but there are many reasons not to build these residences. The main reason I'm protesting building is because of the importance of nature in our lives. The open land we have now is a necessity to keep us animals alive. Robert Gustafson of North White Plains, who identifies himself as the vice chairman of the Libertarian Party in New York State, sent along these comments. One can tell from a generalized statement of the plan that it is cosmetic and won't stand a chance of being implemented. By prohibiting what a property owner can construct on his own property, local governments in Westchester have kept the number of dwelling units artificially low. With demand increasing and the number of units static, the price goes up, thus fewer people can afford to pay rent and more become homeless. Until the right of local governments to zone is strongly modified or abolished, more of us will become homeless. We share these thoughts on the Westchester proposal for homeless housing because we think you should know what your neighbors are thinking, and we urge you to continue to write to us about PIX editorials.
Yeah, I want to run a classified ad in tomorrow's paper. For sale. 83 Honda Prelude. 45,000 miles. AC. Moonroof. AM/FM stereo cassette.
It's never easy parting with a Honda, but it does help to know that a Prelude, for instance, retains its value even better than a Mercedes.
You'll take it?
Honda, the car that sells itself at your New York, New Jersey, Connecticut Tri-Honda dealer.
What you see, change it.
Join Jack LaLanne Holiday Spa for just $24 a month.
TWA kept something in mind when we made our 747 business class seat the widest in the sky. People sometimes cross their legs. After all those meetings in Minneapolis and conventions in Kansas City, we think you could use a little change of pace. And after 40,000 miles in TWA's frequent flyer program, that's just what you get. Today's TWA. Find out how good we really are.
Ever notice that all Japanese imports start to look alike after a while? Here's a different look. The new Buick Regal, with aerodynamic styling and four-wheel power disc brakes. So well-built, it comes with a 6-year, 60,000-mile warranty, plus room for six. Best of all, Regal's less than a comparably equipped Nissan Maxima or Honda Prelude. So with Regal, you'll not only get a car with a different look, you'll save lots of... The new Regal. The right car, the right price. Right now.
Jackie Gleason, The Honeymooners, with the stars Art Carney, Audrey Meadows, and Joyce Randolph.
Gentlemen!
I think my ex-wife is cracking up.
It's a working relationship that's just not working.
How could you send the man I love up in a glass elevator when you know he's afraid of heights?
How could I know he's afraid of heights? He's so tall.
You!
A romance that just won't quit.
Hey, do you know what she did the third time we went out?
Do we ever?
Kathleen Turner, Burt Reynolds, Christopher Reeve, Switching Channels.
Sneak preview tomorrow night at a theater near you.
If you're looking for a great deal on a new car, it's got to be the Dodge President's Birthday Celebration with big cash rebates on most models in stock. Looking for a performance car for $77.45? It's got to be the exciting Dodge Daytona. Want a family car for only $64.95? It's got to be the Dodge Aries America. Or how about a Japanese import for $54.98? It's got to be a Dodge Colt. Everything's priced to move. The big President's Birthday Celebration. It's got to be a Dodge.
Can I see him? I keep him in the bedroom because it's warmer in there. Okay. Put him here.
Oh.